Hello friends, welcome to Indian Mom in Israel. Welcome back. So today is the last day of Hanukkah, and yes, I am home even though it's Sunday because I'm not really feeling well. You can even hear that in my voice. Maybe I have got cold, so I'm home, and I thought since it's the last day of Hanukkah, so I'm making a sweet dish. Yesterday I had made rasmalai and it's all gone. It's over. So today I'm making this gulab jamun. I'm making the gulab jamun out of milk powder. I'm using milk powder because you don't get khoya over here. But you can even make instant khoya out of the milk powder. I will show you that in another video. But for now I'm using this milk powder. So let's start. Here I'm taking, I've taken 1.5 cups of milk powder and 1/4 cup of maida. I have put them both here together. As you can see, this is the maida, and down there in slightly yellow color is the milk powder. Here I've taken 2 tablespoons of ghee. You can use more if needed while making the balls for the gulab jamun. Here I have taken 2 tablespoons of rava, semolina, and approximately 1/3 teaspoon of baking soda. Make sure you're using baking soda in this recipe and not baking powder. Here I have taken 2 teaspoons of lemon juice and approximately 1/4 cup of warm milk. You need it warm, not hot and not too cold. You need it really lukewarm. So that you can touch it while kneading the dough. So these are the ingredients that we'll be using for making our gulab jamun dough. So let's start. So friends, the milk powder I'm using here is this brand, Alban. It comes from Jordan. Okay, it's not produced or made in Israel. So this one is instant fat filled powder, which is 28%, and you can see here it's instant spray dried. If you put it as a coffee mate in your coffees or teas, it's very yummy. I have tried it, but I'm using here this percent fat milk powder. So you can take any of other brands. I don't know what brands you will get in your countries, but you need to use the highest percent one. So here it is 28%, which is a very good quality of milk powder for gulab jamuns and mithais. You can even make nice pedas out of it, or barfi. It's very good for those who are staying abroad and don't have khoya or don't get khoya in their countries. Here we are taking 2 cups of sugar. To that we are going to add 2 cups of water. We are going to take the same quantity. If you're taking 1 cup, then use 1 cup sugar, 1 cup water. If you're taking 2 cups, then use 2 cups sugar and 2 cups water. In case you are splitting this recipe or doubling it. So friends, let's start making the dough. I will add in the semolina and baking soda to my mixture of maida and the milk powder. Let's mix a bit. Let's add the ghee. I'm adding first only 1 tablespoon of ghee. We'll mix it very nicely with the milk powder. Now let's add the lemon juice. Now gradually add in the milk. Add very little at a time, a few tablespoons at a time. You need to make this into a very soft dough because the semolina that we added
will soak in all the moisture and it will be a very dry dough in the end, like the exact consistency that we need. So here, as you can see, it's a very sticky dough. It's a very soft and sticky dough, but it will get to its right texture when we will keep it for rest for a few minutes. It will be the perfect consistency as we want. So now I will add the remaining ghee and knead it again. Friends, as you can see, this dough is not really, it's still very crumbly, but I'm letting this dough rest a bit and then we will adjust the milk again. If needed, I will add more milk and knead it. As of now, I have used half of the milk. As you can see, there is some more milk remaining here, but I'm not adding it now. I will see if I need it again after the dough is rested for a while, I will add it. So now I am covering this with a damp cloth and letting it rest for a few minutes and then we will be back. So friends, it has been approximately 10 minutes now, 10 to 15 minutes, and as you can see, the dough is now crumbling, which means that I will need to add more milk and knead this dough into a proper dough. So I am going to add this remaining milk. I will add half of it for now. Guys, as you can see, the dough is very nice and soft, and I have used ghee again to make it smooth. And here I have still half a tablespoon of milk left, so we have not used all of the milk. So let's start making the jamuns. And to make that, you will have to knead the dough again into between your palms and then make the jamuns like this. Okay, I'm kneading it, as you can see, kneading it very nicely. Don't knead too much so that the ghee doesn't release and then you will have cracks in your jamuns. So here you can see, this is a very smooth jamun. This is the way you need to make all of it. Friends, here you can see all my jamuns are ready, and you can make as big or small as you want. I have made here various sizes, keeping my 2-year-old son in consideration. So I've made a few small ones for him and the normal ones for us, normal size. And my oil is also preheating. Here you can see my oil is preheating, and here this is the sugar syrup that I will be making now. So let's start making both. Here, as I showed you, I have used 2:2 ratio, 2 cups of sugar, 2 cups of water. Once the sugar melts, we will add the lemon juice and the cardamom powder. Here my oil is also ready. Should get cooked from inside as well, so make sure that you fry it on a very low to medium flame.
the sugar syrup we will not cook, we will not we don't need to boil a lot, okay, just a boil and then we will simmer it. So yeah, a boil has come and now I will turn the gas off. We will let it cool a bit before adding the jamuns. I don't add from the oil directly to the syrup, also because the syrup gets too oily, and also because I don't want to add it in the hot syrup. It should be warm but not hot. So what I will do is I have taken out first batch of the gulab jamuns. These look very dark to you, but they are not really burnt. After adding the jamuns to the oil, make sure you keep rotating them, because you can use fork if you are afraid to break them. But you need to keep on rotating them so then they get nice even brown color. So friends, here you can see the jamuns that I take out in a paper towel and then I put them in the syrup. This is the color that most of the people like for the jamuns. But the first batch, actually I purposely made them the darker color. It's not burnt, but it's just dark in color because I personally like that. So you need to take a toothpick, okay, and then you poke it till the end and then take it out. Just one in each. This trick will make sure that the syrup is absorbed properly into each one of them. You have heard many times that the jamun in the middle is hard and only the outer part has soaked the syrup. So this happens when either your jamuns are not really well cooked or your dough was very hard. So this trick, as it is, I do it because then the syrup goes right into the jamuns and they become very moist and soft. So now I am adding these to the syrup. My gulab jamuns are nice and ready. As you can see, I have taken your two jamuns from both the batches to show you that it is cooked all evenly and the syrup has gone right into the middle. Like, it's very very moist and very very soft. So let's cut them and see. So this is the first batch. As you can see, it's dark in color but it's not burnt. See this, it's really very soft. It's very nice and soft. See, this thing in middle, it's not that it's not cooked. As you can see, it releases its syrup. And now this is the other one. It releases the syrup that it has soaked, which means that it's very very moist as well. And if you try this at home, do let me know and send me the pictures. I will be very happy to see how it came out.